I mean, by now we know it's very possible, and we dance bebop, you know, but it's 2018. One of my great mentors, I was lucky to work with Honey Coles, and I told you this in the tap class, and he's amazing, but he and Chelly Atkins were two of the people who, they were a class act, tap dancers, entertainers, and they're two of the people who were very influential, and they said that their careers ended as tap artists when bebop came in. And they said it again and again and again, so it started being written down and people started believing it. They were tap dancers, and they said that their careers ended when bebop came. And this isn't true, but it was a story that helped them, you know, because they're, you know, it was difficult to be an art. It's always difficult to be an artist and figure out how to go from one year to the next. So they kept saying this story, but this really wasn't true. People danced to bebop right as it came into being. But it was hard to dance to, and that was the point. Bebop comes after swing, because when swing got mainstream and we had so many amazing African-American musicians, but then, of course, white artists start taking all of the opportunities. And in the United States, this polarization is very strong, the black and white, and then there's Latino, and then there's Asian, and there's Native. But the black and white is the overarching sort of story of the United States in a certain way. Good, bad, it's, you know, sort of true. And so when, you know, Benny Goodman or who else we want to think of, Chet Baker. So when these artists were becoming sort of the most famous swing artists, younger black artists had to have something that other people couldn't do. And we call this later a style nobody can deal with. A style nobody can deal with. So bebop comes out of this. Well, if we can't work in the big concert halls because all the white artists are doing that, then we need something that they can't do. And bebop, you know, bebop is really hard to understand, hard to play. It's super fast, tends to be. Even when it's slow bebop, the sort of pulse is even faster than swing. It tends to be, it vibrates higher. So the vibration is super, super high, and the tonalities are not pleasing. They're aggressively abstract. And so bebop kind of redesigned jazz and said, well, it could also be this other thing. But it was still dance music, and it was more like the way that the people who weren't doing swing dance that was fun to watch were dancing in this other kind of abstract way. And so bebop and this kind of abstract dancing grow up together. And awkward is a nice way to, you know, kind of describe it. It's awkward dancing. It's like the eccentric dancing from a generation before, but it comes back as bebop dancing. And in that essay, there's also this idea of how do you learn to dance? And, you know, so when you go to the Detroit party that we looked at, you know, it's not like you can do that just because you want to. You have to practice. So people are practicing at home, you know, that, or at home, or in the military, or, you know, maybe in the school locker room. But there's got to be the awkward time where you're practicing before you're actually dancing in a larger public or sort more public sort of commons. So the awkwardness was also about how people had to figure out how to dance with bebop, and how bebop can inspire people to dance, because again, it goes back and forth. So trying to think about that, like the commons that was created then. But if we look at tap dance, for example, tap went from being simply fast to being really abstract in bebop. And in bebop is where we have the roots of rhythm tap. So rhythm tap starts to develop alongside bebop in response to and to help push bebop forward. This is how we get to rhythm tap. And before, you know, we don't have rhythm tap before it, because we have tap dancing that's more like what I was teaching the last few days, that's following the rhythm and responding to it. But in bebop and rhythm tap, you're initiating rhythm and kind of like leading rhythm into new directions through your dancing and through response to kind of abstract sort of licks. So that's part of how the music is different, and the dancing had to be different because of it. But people danced to bebop as it came through in the nightclubs and as tap dancers. And then it really didn't solidify into rhythm tap until like 10 years later. You know, we get people who are really, say, they're rhythm tappers. And then by 20 years later, by the time you get to the late 60s and the 70s, rhythm tap is really clear, you know, and then by the 80s and 90s, it's its own form that most people are practicing now.
Yeah. Just wanted also to ask, like, is there any development in general of these rare art forms into the future? Because, like, what I saw in the videos that we have really few, yeah, about this awkward period of jazz dancing when it was, like, dying, actually. Because, like, what is jazz was also questioned because there are no limits of a genre. As music was evolving, and dance couldn't respond. So, yeah, was it something about, like, really body dancing, or was it about the attitude? One of my teachers, like, told me, if you want to dance bebop, you have to think Snoop Dogg. Because it's all about attitude. Snoop Dogg. Yeah. Like, if you want to dance bebop, you have to think Snoop Dogg, because it's all about attitude and has little to deal with the moves, you know, like it used to be in swing, for example.
I see what you mean, yeah. So it's not about, you know, so swing became something that was defined by shape and actual steps. But again, it didn't start that way. It started about relationship and, you know, again, relationship and social life around. And bebop, you know, bebop, I don't know if I'd say angry, but compared to other forms of black social dance and black music, yeah, it's angry and aggressive. It's definitely nonconformist, so it's more like non-binary, we say now, in terms of like gender, we might say non-binary. And bebop is like that. It's not, it's hard to grasp. It's not one thing, and it's particular. It's very bebop, and bebop dancing, I think, is very concerned with not being easy. So, you know, even in the short video I showed, that was a Thelonious Monk version of All Alone that then we treated and turned into something else. But working with Monk helps, because Monk heard music and then realized it in such unusual ways. Like, he would refuse to let it be obvious. He would always push it to some other place, and bebop does that. I don't know if Snoop Dogg does that. Yeah, but I think Snoop Dogg is pretty clear in his attitude. And if we smoke up, we'll be happy. Is like Snoop Dogg, but there's definitely this a kind of sense of aggressiveness in bebop that you will hear and see us. We won't disappear. Bebop never recedes. Bebop is in front, and swing can sit back. You know, you can sit back and swing, but in bebop, it's going to be in the front. So I don't know. That's interesting. Thank you.